This is Kurt Heisinger, accounting professor at Sierra College and author of Managerial Accounting. This video describes how to use computer software to perform regression analysis, and we're really focusing on regression analysis as it relates to managerial accounting. So the intent of this is not to take the place of a statistics course or statistics video. It's just to simply talk about how we can perform regression analysis using software and apply it to managerial accounting. Regression analysis uses a series of mathematical equations to find the best possible fit of the line to the data points. Remember, what we're doing with regression analysis with respect to managerial accounting is taking historical information, historical cost information, putting it into a regression analysis, and from that getting our total estimate of total fixed cost and variable cost per unit. So a series of mathematical equations are used to get there. One of the best software applications that we can use, or at least the one that we're familiar, most of us are familiar with, is Excel to perform regression analysis. And the goal is for us to come up with, as I mentioned, an estimate of our total fixed cost and variable cost per unit, and then describe it in this equation. I use this equation in several of my videos when I'm talking about estimating total fixed costs, that's F here, and variable cost per unit. So we're going to continue using that equation and talk more about regression analysis using Excel. We'll be working through four steps with this video, and I'm summarizing those four steps here, and we'll look at them in much more detail as we proceed. So step one is to confirm that we have the data analysis package actually installed if we have Excel. So we want to make sure that that's there. If we don't have that, we're not going to be able to actually perform regression analysis. Secondly, we want to enter the data in the spreadsheet. That's the historical cost data that I mentioned in the previous slide. We want to go ahead and enter that data in the spreadsheet because we're going to be using that data to run, step three, the regression analysis. And then once we run the regression analysis, we'll be analyzing the output, and what will come from that output is our total fixed cost estimate, and that was F, and our variable cost per unit, that's V. We'll also talk a little bit about the R-squared statistic and how we can use it to assess the information that comes out of the regression analysis. The first thing that we need to do is to confirm that we have the data analysis package installed within Excel. I'm not going to read through each of these bullet points. I'll let you pause here if you'd like to take a look at this and confirm that you have it in your Excel package on your computer. But take a look at this. If you do not have data analysis, you will not be able to access regression analysis. So make sure you have this installed before moving on. Here's the data that we'll be using for this example. And it's, again, the same data that has been used in several other videos that I've produced related to the estimation of fixed and variable costs. So if you look at those other videos using, for example, account analysis or the high-low method or the scattergraph method to estimate costs, you'll see this exact same data. Feel free to work along with this video as well. You might want to enter this data in your own Excel spreadsheet and then run the regression analysis and see if you can get this to work. So what we're looking at here is the production costs by month for Bikes Unlimited. This is a company that makes mountain bikes and then sells those mountain bikes to retailers. These are the monthly production costs and monthly number of units produced. For example, this first line could be, I think we had the month of July in the other videos. This is for the month of July. It's historical information, so last July. And in that month, the company incurred $230,000 in production costs while producing 3,500 units. So again, and then the next month would be August and right on down the line. So this is historical monthly information that we're going to use to run regression analysis. So how do we run regression analysis using Excel? The steps are here, and again, I'm not going to read through these for you. I'll let you pause the screen. You can take a look at these steps and then go ahead and work this using Excel on your own. And also go back a slide and use the data that's from that slide. So take a look at this, get the data input, and then in the next slide, we're going to take a look at the output and how to use that. Here is the output related to the regression analysis that was run using the data that was provided in the earlier slides. So hopefully you're able to run this in Excel, and you'll see something like this as the output. There's a lot of information here, but let me point out the key three pieces of information that we need related to managerial accounting and estimating costs. So the first two items are right here. And what we're looking at in the first line item here is our total fixed cost. So for row 17, we're looking at, and for column B, we're looking at fixed costs in total of $43,276. And then for row 18, this is our variable cost per unit. Our variable cost per unit then in this example is $53.42. So those are the two key pieces of information that we're going to show on the next slide that we'll input into the equation. We also need to take a look at the R squared, which is right here, and we're going to be referring to that data as well on the next slide. As I mentioned in the previous slide, the output shows that we have total estimated fixed costs of $43,276. And we have the variable cost per unit estimate of $53.42. Our cost equation, therefore, looks like this. If we're going to estimate our total costs, remember these are production costs for any given month, we're going to take our total fixed costs and we'll add to that our variable cost per unit times the number of units that we expect to produce in the future for any given month. And once we plug X in, we can run the numbers to determine what our total costs are expected to be. Most statistics experts would tell you that we need to do some further analysis, that it's not good enough just to enter the data, take the output, and use it as though it's 100% accurate. And there are some ways to assess whether that information is truly going to help us or not. And one of the first places to start is with the R-squared measure. The R-squared measure tells us the percent of the variance in the dependent variable, which by the way here is total production costs, is explained by the number of units produced. And according to the R-squared statistic in the printout in the previous slide, you'll see that, and I circled it earlier, you'll see that 96.29% of the variance in total production cost is explained by the level of units produced. In other words, that's a pretty strong way to predict cost if we use the number of units that we expect to produce and the equation in the previous slide, that will give us a fairly accurate estimate looking into the future, which is the point being made here with the third bullet point. And finally, I want to make sure it's clear, this is again not meant to be a statistics video. If you want to get more information about how to interpret statistics data, you need to go to more specific information within a statistics course or a video that is addressing statistics specifically. The intent of this video is to show you how to use Excel to run regression analysis.